Hello, welcome back to the channel. Bit of a different one today. We've got a question and answer video. So a Q&A.
Yep.
I asked for questions on Instagram.
As did I.
And yeah, a bit more of a personal one. I hope you do enjoy. Let's get into the questions.
Cheers.
So first question is from Vicky on Instagram. She said, how did you meet being so far apart?
So I'm originally from Plymouth, which is in Devon in the UK, and John Luke is from Manchester, Middleton,
Manchester,
specific,
yeah.
And that's also in the UK. If you're watching from the States, we know we've got a few viewers elsewhere. Do you want to tell the story?
So I took a year off from making videos due to personal reasons, etc, etc. Came back and I made the video, where did John Luke go, I think it was.
Yep, and before John Luke took his break, I'd watched a few of his videos because I had dabbled in reselling, wondered where he'd gone. We've told the story before, but I was searching on YouTube, boy who resells, I couldn't remember his name.
Yeah, it just wasn't that memorable.
There wasn't very many YouTube resellers at the time.
Yeah, not as many.
Not as many at all, all over.
All she had to type in was car boot, and then she would have found it.
Trust me, it was just,
anyway, you messaged me on Instagram about tax. As everyone else does, you know what I mean? I like the tax questionnaire.
I just started officially doing my reselling, trying to set up all up as a, you know, proper business. And I was like, oh, I'll ask him, because he's my age. I didn't know very many resellers my age. It's normally, like, people not in my our age bracket.
Yeah. And then we got chatting. Then I had a holiday in Cornwall, like,
by chance,
the week of. And then we met up. And then we never looked back.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Moved down shortly after.
Yeah.
Going on to that question, Vicky did say, was it hard fitting in the family home? It was fine, wasn't it?
Yeah, at the beginning, from July where we met, we both did week in Manchester, week in Plymouth. Because of our job, we could just be flexible. So I'd go up for a week or 10 days at a time, then we'd have a 4-day break and go
yeah.
And then John would come here, and then he officially moved in January time,
mm-hmm.
December, January. But we haven't really spent any time apart since we first met because, yeah.
Question from Tommy Trades, what's the best date you've been on together? I was going to say it wasn't like a date, but it was when we watched the sky out here.
Yeah, on one of the first months we met, July or August, we laid out stargazing, and it was my first time in my life ever seeing shooting stars. We saw about 3 or 4, and we had a bottle of wine and blankets, and it was just like us and nobody else, no phones, just darkness, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was nice.
We're not really sort of people to go out for meals at restaurants or dates, like we spend so much time together just charity shopping.
Yeah, we do now and again.
Yeah.
But we spend a lot of time together anyway, so every day is kind of...
Yeah, we work together all day in the warehouse, yeah, and then fall asleep together.
Yeah.
Every day is a date day.
Bob says hello.
Hello, Bob.
Says, what would you say to a 10-year-old you?
10-year-old me? Probably not to be... I even remember, as a little girl, I've always suffered with really like chronic OCD, and it started when I was about 10 or 11. And I would just check everything. I spent about 40 minutes in the morning counting. I had each book I needed to bring in.
Yeah.
I remember at the front door. So I'd probably just tell myself, it's all going to be okay. Don't worry over things that haven't happened yet, and you'll find your way.
Mm-hmm.
You?
I would say just put everything you got on Bitcoin.
Cash out.
Everything you got. Everything you got, put it on Bitcoin. And also...
What, to a 10-year-old you?
I'd just say, you know, the first thing you hear of Bitcoin, just start buying it. Start buying it. No, I wouldn't say anything too serious. Like, when I was 10, I was kind of...
Vibing.
Just a vibey, normal kid. Got bullied a little bit, as does a lot of people, do you know what, yeah, I mean? Like, you know, children are quite awful at times, aren't they?
So now it's came along, that little word.
Yeah, so it's just to keep smiling and be happy and trust the process.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Joy being young.
Mm-hmm. Rolls Alam says... Did you say you have a kid with Charlotte already? Hey,
well,
to the no.
Oh, I was going to do a well, guys.
No, we don't.
No.
The child you've seen on the videos is Charlotte's nephew.
Yeah. We live with my mum and dad currently, and my mum and dad have him a few days a week, so he's always making an appearance.
Yeah.
And he's 3.
Shout out to Ted.
Future reseller?
Possibly. Or van driver?
Yeah.
For us?
We'll get him doing waste removals and then route the trucks. That's
mm-hmm.
a good... He's really strong, isn't he?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, stay tuned for 20 years' time.
Dan's Bargain Shed said, what was your guy's job before you'd on eBay? What did you work as?
So from about 16, I've always worked in beauty. I worked for Superdrug for about 3 years doing the beauty counters and the fragrance, and then I went to Boots, and then after that I was a makeup artist on Chanel and other counters. I did all the counters like on agency, and then after my degree I got a job as a social media assistant doing all their writing and blogging, and yeah, always beauty related. But I have also done a week at McDonald's, can't forget that one. Just a week.
I've never done McDonald's.
Should do for the free lunch.
I was lifeguard. Well, I was in college, part-time lifeguard, and then I went full-time lifeguard. Did swimming teaching as well from kids the age of 3 to about 14. Not 3 till about 12, I'd say. So yeah, full-time swim teaching, full-time lifeguarding. Then I left and then worked on the sales team at Vodafone. Then left there and went and lifeguarded a bit more. And then I jumped ship to Plymouth. Obviously doing eBay in and out of all that stuff, like on and off, you know, lots of mental breakdowns and all, you know, mishaps in between. But that's kind of what happened.
Yeah, I've always like worked since I actually in school too, worked as a dinner lady on my lunchtime in high school.
That's a bit sad, isn't it?
It was good money. It was like five for 20 minutes work. Anyway, I've always had a job since I was about 14.
You're just a worker, aren't you? Hey?
Yeah.
You're a grafter in the coal mines. Imagine her in the coal mines.
That's
up here. Amy Louise on Instagram says, would you move anywhere else in the UK?
Never say never. We like to think we're open books and pages, don't we?
Yeah, definitely.
I don't think Plymouth and Devon will be our forever home. Definitely not. It just serves us well right now. It just serves us well right now. We've got good contacts. We're happy. We're saving up. But who knows? I'd be open to move to a few places.
Yeah, me too.
I think it'll be nice to be more Bristol way, Somerset, to be halfway
centrally
through Manchester.
Yeah, we're a little bit out of the way down here. But yeah, I'm happy down here, to be fair, like, but there's no like rush to get out of here.
I wouldn't mind living in Manchester, but I know John wouldn't want to go back there. Maybe somewhere like Bath or
just a little bit closer to London or a little bit closer to Manchester, you know what I mean? Just kind of upwards
a little bit. We're 2 or 3 hours.
Yeah, we're just a little bit out of it at the minute, Midland somewhere. The Big Bear 1989 says, we know JL has his collections, but does Charlotte collect anything?
No.
Yeah, you're not really a collector, are you?
I do like
you have
makeup
like,
and fragrance, but...
Yeah, no crazy collections.
No crazy collections, no. I've always, as I said before, OCD, I've really always struggled with huge accumulations of stuff.
Yeah, you have simplistic, simple way of life. You don't have too much stuff.
No, but I...
She has a lot of coats.
I've got a crazy coat collection.
Yeah. It's not like, wow, she's got like a Burberry coat or anything. You just got a lot of like bang average coats, haven't you?
Oh, I wouldn't say bang
average. No, I mean they're nice, but they're like, you're not like...
High street,
You're not like a luxury collector or anything.
No, if I had
nice
the money, coats, I would love a vintage designer handbag collection. I'd love
you want a Chanel bag,
I'd love a 90s Chanel flat bag.
Wouldn't we all? Wouldn't we all? Should have married a richer man.
Anyone want
to
hook me up?
One day I'll give you that bag, okay?
Yeah, I need $6,000. It's an investment, they go up in price every year.
Well, we should have bought one a few years ago.
That's what I said to Dad every day, I tell him.
Sam sells stuff, says, when wedding?
Well. we've always said from the first week of getting married, first week of meeting, we want to get married.
Yeah, one day, Sam. One day. We want to get married in... like Lake Como or in Greece somewhere. Nice holiday.
And I do want John to do the first proposal, but I also equally want to do a proposal as well with abroad with a ring, and I think it's nice to do it back. It's not all one-sided these days, is that you're equal partners. I want you to have a special memory.
Of course. Saf sells stuff. Do you believe in ghosts?
Yes.
I do.
I think you're very naive if you think, this
is it.
Yeah, this is it. Same with
space,
we'll probably touch on that in a minute. Yeah, there's so many entities and
we can only see like through our eyes, like we can't see different dimensions. There could be like other stuff in front of us we just can't see.
I think if you say no, you're cutting yourself off. We like to always say
it's like there's certain bugs and certain animals and insects or whatever that can't see us. They can see other things. Do you know what I mean? Like they have different vision. Like people see an infrared, and like, well, not people, I mean, like, different animals, they've seen colours, like yeah. cats don't see certain colours. And
I have had really nice experiences with like the other side.
Yeah.
Like my grandpa always said to me when he passed away, he'd come back as a robin, and I continuously see him when I need to. Do you know what I mean? Remember once I was at school and I was like, I had an exam and I was like, I really like need to see a sign from a robin today. And I opened my curtains and he was right on the windowsill.
Yeah.
And then like we saw him on his death of his anniversary, didn't he? And he was like right on our car.
Yeah.
And stayed
yeah.
there for ages.
Yeah.
Just little things like that.
Yeah, and I've heard some like really cool
yeah.
like ghosty spirit stories from like credible people yeah. that I know. So I'll tell them on another day.
My mum is super like, don't believe in it. Like, oh no, it's awful. I'm not scared of anything. Her and dad stayed in a hotel when they visited me in uni, and it was a wood floor in the bedroom. My mum said in the night she could hear heavy, really thick boots and coins dropping on the floor. She just thought I'm on dreaming or
yeah.
she was awake. Then when they checked out the next day, she was like, oh gosh, really weird activity in that room with like sounds and banging. And they were like, oh yeah, that's our most haunted room. Like every guest says that, we've had it checked out. So,
yeah, it's crazy. Like, so yeah,
for sure.
To answer the question, yes, we do. Benjamin McLean said, do you believe in the supernatural as well? So yeah.
Yeah.
We do.
I'd like to know other people's ghost experiences or supernatural.
Yeah, yeah, any of your answers to these questions as well, get them down below and get chat going.
I'd like to know if anyone's had sleep paralysis, or you know when you can do those things where you go above your body and look down, like
like outer body experiences,
stuff. I would like to know that. Yeah.
Benjamin also says, what sport would you like to be a professional in other than football, if you could be a sports person?
Up until I was about 12, I did figure skating, and I did that to like bronze level. You get like different levels in the UK. I did 1 to 12, and then you start at bronze. But then I stopped. It was a lot of money, too expensive. But I do really enjoy going. It's just quite physical. I can't do that as much.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I love figure skating.
I'd say Formula One. So like racing.
Every day with you, my love, Alice. Mm.
No, but that's what I mean. But if I could do it as a professional,
yeah,
like it'd be Formula One, definitely. You know, when you get a buzz like going around someone on the motorway or something. Like imagine that, like twice, three times as fast with a big crowd.
No, anyone stays tight to a corner as John Luke.
You know what I mean? You've got to tight to the corner, get around the corner quick, you know what I mean? Benjamin also says, what do you think will happen when you die? No idea, not sure. But I'm sure there's something good that happens. And I kind of keep to that, like, there's something else.
I wonder if, with human powers, there'll ever be an answer to that technology that can give us.
No, but I think when you pass over, they'd be able to look at the humans and go, you know what I mean? Like,
you don't know what's coming.
Yeah, you don't know what's coming kind of thing. I think there's something else.
I like to think of reincarnation.
Yeah, there's something else.
You get those kids that say, oh, I used to live with a family in Ireland, and they like know every graphic detail.
Yeah, and they know every person and that. But, yeah, crazy stuff. There's definitely something else. There's something else. Our soul, you know, there's something in there. Gigi Blossom, shout out to Gigi. She said, will you guys ever get a pet? Yeah, we want to get two cats. We want to get two ragdoll cats.
Yeah.
We're both cat people.
Always had a cat, not a dog.
Mm-mm-mm. I've had three cats in my life.
I've had
and a guinea pig and a fish.
I've had a guinea pig. I did have a dog for a short while, but yeah, maybe just cut that bit out. So. We want to have.
You couldn't hack it, could you? Weren't
no,
for you.
I couldn't. It wasn't so much that I did such good training, such good care of it, but I just physically couldn't keep up.
Yeah.
He's got a beautiful family now.
Yeah.
And I keep in contact with them. But yeah, we're going to call our cats North and South for obvious reasons. We've decided that since day one, haven't we?
Mm-hmm. Ben's thread says, do you and Charlotte compete with each other when it comes to selling? We don't compete, we help each other out. But like, Charlotte will go, oh, I had a £200 day today. And I'll be like, yeah, I've had a £201. I mean, so we have.
You like to do that at the
yeah,
end of the day.
Yeah, we can't, you know what I mean? Like.
And the only time I do feel tiny bit bitter is if you get something I would love for my own store, like sea salt dress or something. I'm like, oh.
Yeah, but we still give each other a lot of stuff as well.
It's if anything, it's not competition. It's like the healthiest encouragement you could
do. It's like healthy competition.
I wouldn't do half the well if I didn't have you.
Yeah. Yeah, we both help each other out in different ways. We've got a strong, strong bond. Sean says on Instagram, she says, how did the panda obsession start?
Show him skinny.
So yeah, we've got
just the reference of how strong the, if you don't know,
we've got the IKEA panda now on my skin. That is from the IKEA website. It's called Skinny because he lives on the skin. But yeah, I had one of these pandas before I met Shah, and then, you know, obviously me and Shah met, then we just loved him together.
Our bond, because me and John were like growing and loving, like he was just always there on the bed with us, like, and I feel like he's just been there since the start.
Yeah.
And then like we have little nice interactions between them and just like have fun, don't we?
Yeah, we're like big kids. Big kids.
They do have their own accents and voices and their personality.
Yeah.
They're...
Yeah, we're just big kids and we enjoy the smaller things in life. Yeah. Can't take it too seriously.
I'd like to know if anyone can name our pandas down below.
Yeah, that'd be good. So if anyone's been paying attention.
Yeah.
We've got Skinny, of course.
They're all called S because the first one was obviously Slowpoke. Yeah.
Yeah.
At the start, I think you can see.
Yeah. But yeah, we've got two big pandas, two little pandas.
Yeah.
And other animals as well.
IKEA. And
yeah.
We have just started a jelly cat. A
couple of jelly cats as well. Yeah.
And I will be getting a Dubai jelly cat.
Mm.
Or a London jelly cat.
Yeah.
Maybe both.
Exciting.
Yeah.
I'm the messy one.
I'll just wait for him to say it so
yeah,
it doesn't.
Yeah. I'm the messy one.
John Luke is very clean, but messy.
I gotta clean my hands and stuff. Bloody hell. It's like being in the Amazon rainforest.
What was that noise?
But yeah, I'm messy. Charlotte's got OCD, so she's like... ultra clean OCD. I just mean like, you're not as messy, basically.
Yeah,
I didn't use that as an excuse.
I like things ordered.
Yeah.
But John can be tidy and organised, but he just lets things get a bit chaotic before he gets it all rocked up again.
Yeah.
And then he gets messy again.
Yeah, I can't really like maintain the cleanliness.
Yeah.
I like tidiness,
you're very clean.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm not like one of those guys with like no bed sheet on like the mattress, like, you know what I mean? Where like crisp packets on the mattress, like.
It always had, when I first met him, it was like his room was like a dream, like two pillows on each side, blankets, candles.
Yeah, and then just
like...
a lot of collections. So,
yeah.
Like my stuff.
Yeah.
A lot of stuff, I like stuff. I do like stuff and a lot of stuff.
And that's
when we buy a house, gonna have a lot of stuff.
That's helped me heal a lot, like helped me not be so.
What do you mean?
Like, I didn't cope very well before, like loads of stuff, did I?
But obviously working in this job as well, you deal with a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Like, if you're going out of unit now, it's just stuff. But it's stuff in order as well.
Yeah.
We have order to everything that we do.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm the messy one.
So Vintage Harrison on Instagram has asked us, what are your plans whilst you're in London?
So yeah, we drive to London on Monday, and we fly on holiday on Wednesday.
Yeah.
So we've got like a full day Tuesday, a little bit of a day on Monday, a little bit of a day on Wednesday as well. We've not got any particular plans, like we have done London before, with and without each other.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's just kind of chilling, getting some shopping in, some nice meals. We put some money aside for like some nice things, basically.
Mm-hmm. I think we're gonna go into Borough Market in Camden and Soho.
Yeah,
and just, you know, go to the Browse and just see where we end up.
Wear sunglasses and chill.
Yeah.
I do want to go Forbidden Planet because obviously that's my favourite shop in Manchester. So I want to see the London shop. I've never been before.
Yeah. As people, we both work best with no fixed plans for date and time.
Yeah, we don't really book stuff because it's just we don't know how we're gonna feel on the day, like mentally and physically. So it's just kind of working it that way. So yeah, we're excited for it though, aren't we?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah. We'll get plenty done.
So user...
I just say is.
So is ISB. Has asked us tips to keeping a relationship happy and strong. Do you want to start?
Communicating well. I'd say. Communicating.
Yeah. What we've always said to each other before, you can't always be 100% and 100%. One day you may need to make 80, the other person can only give 20, but together you make that 100.
Yeah.
One day someone will feel lower than the other, you can't expect 100 out of 100.
Yeah, it can't always be 50-50, you mean.
And I think just the best thing is healthy communication, not to get into moods.
Yeah, and it's different per couple as well. We enjoy being around each other. Some couples might need a bit of space during the day as well, do you know what I mean?
All we've ever known is spending all day and all evening together.
Yeah, so that's why we got a bit stir crazy with pandas and stuff.
But yeah, luckily we've never really argued or anything, have we?
No.
Like anybody, we have little bickers or days where things are a bit crappy, but...
Yeah, but we're always fine, like before we go to bed.
Yeah, just the best thing to do. Oh, do you know what I read once, which is a really important moment? If you're upset about something, let it brew for a few hours. And if you still feel like that a few hours or a few days later, bring it up then, because sometimes in the heat of the moment you can say things you regret or things that feel more important than they are.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Yeah, just
I agree.
Talk things out and remember that you're both a team.
That what I was about to murder you, but then I let myself brew for a few 3 hours, and I was like, you know what? I'm glad I didn't murder her.
It's you two against the problem, not the other way around.
Yeah. Thank you for the question.
Yeah. Somebody asked me, if you had to rename eBay, what would it be?
I don't even know why it's called eBay. I don't know, it's just
like e-commerce, and then bay because it's like a rise in the shops.
Yeah, I don't know. Sounds a bit...
think that sounds a bit realistic, to be honest.
But yeah, I don't know. What would you rename eBay? The John Luke Marketplace. Boom.
John Luke Industry.
Just whack your name on it. Do you know what I mean? No, I don't know. eBay is just a perfect name. Do you know what I mean? You wouldn't want to rename it.
It is eBay, yeah. I think the E is from e-commerce, like online selling.
E, like electronic bay or something. Yeah, definitely.
A bay is like where ships go, so it's like all shops together in one place. That is the breakdown of eBay according to Savvy Stylist 2022.
Yeah.
Someone from eBay, please let me know.
Yeah, bet you can quick Google it and let you know.
All right then. Let's find out.
Echo Bay. So it means Echo Bay.
Referring to acoustic sound and waves in electronic commerce is similar to what I said.
Yeah,
Echo Bay. Back in 1995, it was originally called Auction Web.
That makes sense. But yeah, Auction Web wouldn't have been that great, would it?
Yeah.
Anyway, what was your last question from Tommy? Final question.
So Tommy Trades 96 on Instagram. Do you feel that you've made it? At what point will you feel like you've made it?
I don't feel like that now, for sure. I feel like that when we've got a nice stable home.
Financial
freedom to an extent. Like, obviously, it's hard to become financially free from...
Almost to not worry about bills or money, a few nice holidays, just be comfortable.
Yeah, but definitely having a house and a forever home would be nice.
Yeah, our own home.
Yeah. Maybe not my first home, like, forever home. Like, and I don't want to feel like we've made it, because then... I always want to push.
I always like to think you've made it just from like the small wins in a day. Do you know what I mean? You can really feel that out of the tiny things.
Yeah, like you can make it in a day. Like I always try and set small goals in a day.
Try and smash those targets. You're 1% better than yesterday. You've done good. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You can find small wins in every day.
Yeah. Hey. So I hope you did enjoy today's video. A little bit of a different one, but you know, hope you enjoyed our company. If you did, leave a like, leave a nice comment, and we will see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching, bye.
Peace.